Hello. Welcome, everyone. Hi. Thank you all for coming. My name is John McDonald. I'm a shareholder here at Godfrey & Kahn on our corporate team. I'm also chair of our co-chair of our Emerging Companies Practice Group. We're really happy you all were able to make it today, and really want to congratulate the Scalerator 4 cohort, or cohort 4 of the Scalerator program. And hope you all enjoy the space, and thank you all for attending. We're really proud to be a sponsor of Scale Up Milwaukee and of this program. The mission of Scale Up Milwaukee to help build the entrepreneurial community here in Milwaukee is a vital need for our city and for the area, and we're very supportive of this program, and I think some of its results speak for themselves. I mean, the numbers that I've heard just from this class, I understand since the program began last year, they've already hired more than 50 people, new employees, and I understand that nearly 500 employees have been hired by all the different companies that have gone through the four different programs since they've gone through the program. So that's a great number. The kind of success we really need to see in Milwaukee and the kind of growth that we really need to see happen, so it's great. In case you don't know much about Godfrey & Kahn, we're a full-service business law firm here, based here in Milwaukee. Our guide is that we judge our success by the success of our clients. And I've had the opportunity to work with a lot of wonderful and amazing and a variety of entrepreneurs, investors, and CEOs who thankfully have a much higher risk tolerance than I do. And again, we want to congratulate the fourth cohort for making it through the program, and wish you all the success in the future. Next, we have Jerry.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Jerry Gendus. I'm one of the co-chairs of Scale Up Milwaukee with Dave Warner. And I'm going to talk just a little bit about growth and why I'm involved with Scale Up Milwaukee. So the main reason is because of all of you, and some of those stats to go in a little bit more. $40 million in 2016 revenues being increased just from those companies involved in Scalerator 4. 51 new hires. Grew 38% in 2016, projected to grow another 39% in 2017. And I think the Scalerator companies going through the program and thinking about growth, a culture of growth, and how that can be contagious. Whether it's how you support your customers, it's how you do innovation. There's a variety of things that go into allowing for the greater Milwaukee region to grow. And Scale Up Milwaukee is a big part of it, along with some other organizations. So I'm very proud and privileged to be a part of Scale Up. I think that we all should provide these Scalerator companies a great round of applause right now. And I'm very curious and interested to hear what you all have to say as we go through this program. Right now, I'd like to invite up Lee Swindell from the WEDC. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Jerry. Good afternoon, everyone. Before I begin, I just wanted to introduce to you two sector directors for WEDC that are present here today in our division, Kelly Armstrong and Gail McCaskill. If you'd just stand and be recognized, please. Okay. Elizabeth has instructed me to be mercifully short with you, so I will be. My name is Lee Swindell. I'm the Vice President of Sector Strategy Development for the Wisconsin Economic Development Corporation. We are a proud first charter supporter for the Scalerator program and Scale Up Milwaukee. And we are very proud to support Scale Up Milwaukee and Scalerator and the growth of the companies that participate in this program, because with the availability of the specialized services delivered in this model, we are now able to actively and directly serve a quadrant of the market that historically has been underserved, and that is smaller companies in need of rapid growth and expansion. We had no other services previously targeted at this point of the company. We do, and it's been a highly successful undertaking. We generally support strategies that generate real results for real Wisconsin businesses, and this effort alone has yielded about a net plus 500 new jobs since 2013 by directing our investment funding towards Scalerator. And we are extremely pleased. I would say, arguably, the results have well exceeded our initial expectations. So it's been a very wise investment indeed. So with no further delay, I'm going to introduce to you the gentleman who's called the Dean of the Scalerator, and that is Professor Vinny Onyema, who will be speaking to you next.
Good morning again, or good afternoon. No, is it afternoon or morning? Does it matter? This is a party, this is, we're celebrating. So I'm very happy to see our new babies. But you know, when in a family babies are born, we have to be careful not to pay too much attention to the babies. Otherwise, the big brothers and the big sisters are going to get very jealous, right? So as a result, I want to just take a moment to recognize the presence of big brothers and big sisters, alums of the Scalerator program. So if you don't mind, just stand up briefly so that we can see you, so that I can give you the attention. So please, round of applause. Thank you. So each of these brothers and sisters, big brothers and sisters, they have unique stories. But in the interest of time, I'm going to just call on two of them to come here and share with us what has happened in their lives since we gave birth to them. I mean, in quote. So I have the privilege of introducing Jamie Downey of Sleep Institute. Jamie, please.
Thanks, Vinny. Jamie Downing, I was a member of the second cohort for the Scalp Milwaukee program. Proud of it, stay engaged. I attended a Scalp event last week. It was an HR event. I'm the president of the company, but jumped out of my shell a little bit and attended a different event. So I stay engaged, and it's been great for us. I'm a near West Side company, about 10 million in revenue, about 70 employees. We provide clinical, educational, and treatment excellence to patients with sleep disorders. Our growth story is we want to be the Midwest leader, providing a better life through better sleep. We're 23 years strong, so we're pretty embedded in the community and are interested in growing. I would say our biggest growth story is not that we've grown significantly, because we are a fairly sizable company, but it's really focused on making us grow up. We're pretty particular. We're in healthcare. We are connected to America's largest Catholic health system in America, Ascension. We're trying to bring jobs to Milwaukee as well. So our potential growth story, we've accomplished the first phase of it. The second phase of it is about 40% growth, keeping jobs in this market and connecting ourselves inside the Ascension Wisconsin platform. We're pretty excited about that. Every day, it's no small task. It's a $30 billion company, and we're a small company and small potatoes compared to that. So we're excited about the possibilities of growth and keeping jobs here, and as we continue to be part of the program and the Scale program in Milwaukee. So thanks for having me. Congratulations to the recent graduates. And I would suggest to you to stay involved and stay engaged. It's a great program.
Thank you, Steve. So I'm going to call on Matt Carroll. Matt?
I wrote down all of the things that Elizabeth wanted me to say, so I didn't forget them. Is that a timer?
Yeah.
Should have wrote in bigger font. I'm Matt Carroll. I'm the president of the AccuTrans Group and a proud alumni of Scalerator Cohort Number 3. AccuTrans is a Milwaukee-based, globally operating chauffeured ground transportation firm. Our fleet consists of executive sedans, SUVs, vans, mini coaches, and stretch limousines. I think it's very important that I say that I wrote down that whole sentence in Scalerator 3 classes. Our primary focus is corporate travel. We provide airport transportation for executives, guests. We handle group movements, corporate convention services, and a broad scope of retail work. The Scalerator program has benefited our firm with very measurable results. Prior to attending Scalerator 3, we were stagnant. Our sales were flat, margins were small, and we struggled with growth. I hung on every word that Vinny said. And everything seemed so exciting. Then the results started to happen, and that was very exciting, is still very exciting. After a mere 2 months of attending classes, I had purchased an additional 2 companies, making our total exposure to 5 brands. The Scalerator course has taught us how to use metrics to better our internal operations, focus to measure ongoings that we had previously not considered. If you measure it, you can control it. If you can control it, you can repeat it. We were able to improve cash flow, create and implement a successful business plan, and streamline our operations for maximum efficiency. As of right now, our sales are over 100% above what they were prior to starting the Scalerator program. Elizabeth didn't tell me to say that. I wrote that one down myself. We have added multiple positions, and we've added new and diverse equipment. Our new equipment has been obtained through Daring Leasing, who is also part of the Scalerator 3 class. I'm sure Elmer is excited to hear that. We're very excited for what is to come. I'm truly grateful for the Scale Up program and the great things they are doing for Milwaukee's business climate. It means a lot. So congratulations to the Scalerator 4 graduates. I wish you all the success in that you do. Make sure you measure, grow, and repeat. And thank you for your time.
Elizabeth, are we doing okay?
Yeah, we're good.
Good. In the spirit of recognizing everyone here and our sponsors, I just saw Julia. Julia there? Do you know Julia?
Yes.
Okay. Can you give it for her, okay? Because for years now, she's been there promoting, and of course, give it to her. Voila. You all know Dave, of course. Dave, you didn't stand up. They didn't see you.
Dave.
No. of course, you know the Greater Milwaukee Council have been a huge supporter of all this since day one. So I just want us to, again, to keep that in mind. And so without 35 seconds, okay. So I change course. Dan Eisenberg, the guru of Scalerator, I need you here. Dan, can you give Dan a round of applause? Dan is the brain, is the brain, the blood, the muscle, the mind behind
the
our.
Beauty. Oh, you're the beauty.
So Dan is the thought leader of the reason why we're here today. And then when he came to Babson, he started this off, and then this has grown, and then we're here today. So Dan, you've been here, you've been there, and then it's great to see you involved and engaged as usual. And I want us to give a big round of applause to the person that made this possible, that make possible for us to be here today. Okay. And then Dan is going to do us the honor of giving out the certificates for the graduates, the people that are leaving the program today. They are leaving, but they're going to stay engaged. And when I call them up, they will come up, but I want Dan to say just a few words before I start calling them up. And when they come here, before they take their certificates, they have a final exam to take. And the exam is that they have to tell us whether they've grown and how much they've grown. And if they've not grown, there's the ocean just behind us here. We know what to do. So Dan, you want to say a few words, and I start calling our new bonds up.
Thanks, Finney. And of course, you know that none of this could be done without the unique guidance and leadership and pedagogical inputs of Vinny. So I think we should also give Vinny a really big hand. We've run now 10 Scalerators together, Vinny and I, and the results are surprisingly the same. I won't say it's boring, because it's not. Growth is exciting, seeing companies scale up, seeing you achieve your dreams, even exceed your dreams, seeing you serve your employees, serve your communities, serve your customers, which is probably the most important thing, serve your investors, your shareholders, and your bankers. These are all the most exciting things that I think a person can experience in his or her life. And I'm talking about myself as the observer from close to all this growth. For me, the most important things are the approximately $250 million of revenues that cumulative revenues of all the Scalerator alums and their companies that they represent. $250 million is a big number. And that's the cumulative sales, of course. I call that economic engagement, because as those $250 million grow, and we're shooting for $1 billion, we've gone on record on that 3 years ago saying, and I think most of us, including ourselves, thought that we were probably crazy, but it's within reach. And what happens when in a community, at $250 million or $500 million starts growing by 10 or 15%, that has impact. The most of the spend is in salaries and in suppliers. That's mostly local. And as that increases, it helps the local communities. The investment, the wealth that's created, most of that stays local. Not all of it. That's not natural, but a lot of it does stay local. The supply chains that get developed tend to be local supply chains. So these are real drivers, and you're real drivers of future prosperity in the city and in Milwaukee. So I think that's really a wonderful thing that you're all being part of and you're all contributing to. And I know you're not contributing it to contribute it. You're contributing it because you're motivated by wealth, by impact, by recognition, and of course by contributing to the community. Those are all important things. So with no further commentary, I think we'll get to the...
Yes, so when I call you, you come in through your right, and make sure you go through this place. Make sure, underlined. So we have Chris Ben of Ben Enterprises. No, don't give them the certificate until they tell the story.
Thank you. My name is Chris from Bear Enterprises. I'm the owner of Bear Enterprises. We are a metal fabrication company. We take metal of all sizes. We laser cut it, water jet it, form it, weld it, and ship it. From quantities of one for a stainless steel counter to millions, I hope. With that, we've also had our best first quarter ever. We're up 33% than we are last year, which is typically... which has been typically our worst quarter on the year. It actually is our fifth best quarter in the 12 years that we've been in business. With that, we've also had some internal growth, made some structure changes on the way, how we get it done, which has really helped. And by the end of this year, I'm hoping to be looking at a new building, because our lease is up and we're very tight, as Elmer saw last week. And looking at some new equipment, and with both of those go more employees. Thank you.
Thank you. Yeah, now you can give. Yeah, he deserves one. He deserves one. Frank of Brew City. Brew City Frank. I will shake you, and you tell the story, and okay, if you walk out, you get the certificate.
Okay, if not, I go to the...
No, in the ocean. Yeah.
Okay, all right. I'm the underdog here. All right, I'm Frank from Brew City Brand Apparel. We are a Milwaukee-based family business with over 30 years of experience developing products for the retail marketplace. And since joining Scale, some amazing things have happened to us. Our sales have been up by about $250,000. And 2016 was our best year on record in our 31 years. We switched banks for the first time to secure financing vital for our growth. We hired a CFO. We evolved into an S corporation. We added 10 new jobs. We added a second automatic press to our production area and relaunched our website. In 2017, we hope to be launching a brand new retail store, our biggest store yet. So I would like to thank Elmer, Elizabeth, Heather, Vinny, everybody involved with Scale Up and allowing us to go on your journey with you. Thank you. Oh.
You're making impact.
I almost
did. The impact of your growth.
And where do we go to buy your products?
Oh, Grand Avenue, Southbridge, Public Market.
Good.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Fred. Flutter, Central Office Systems.
Now, the last time somebody gave me a microphone and I was this drunk, it did not turn out very well. So, but anyway, and I promise less than 8 minutes, I said. So, year-over-year growth for Central Office Systems. We're an office equipment company. We take care of things like laser printers, copiers, scanners, all types of devices on your network. I'm the on-ramp and the off-ramp for your computer network. And we're the best office equipment company in this marketplace. We also opened a location in Appleton just recently, so our company's been growing and growing. Year over year, comparatively to when I started Scalerator, I went back the last 6 months, we're up $544,405 year over year. And that's 60.8% growth. I'm not going to tell you how much we're up in profit, but our profitability is up 23.12%.
Yes!
So, and we added four jobs. We're adding two more on Monday. So, very excited. I just want to thank everybody for the opportunity to participate. This was really just a great experience, and thank you so much for having me as a member here. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. You have Harry, Convenience Electronics.
Sorry, Art.
Art? No.
I gave him the wrong one.
Ooh la la.
No, I get this one. This is mine now. We just acquired a company.
I've heard of
company. He didn't realize it was that easy.
My name is Harry Lum, and I'm with a company called Convenience Electronics, and Scale Up Milwaukee is expanding its reach because I'm in Madison, Wisconsin. And I can tell you, starting this and my goals, we've been floundering around $4 million for the last 3 years. I want to grow.
Yeah.
Scale Up Milwaukee's given me the structure to finance my growth, to set up my capacity so that we can grow. We've been hitting our on-time delivery 100% for 22 months now, but we've not been growing. This year, because of Scale Up Milwaukee, they've given me that structure that we can add to our company to make sure that when we onboard people, they're productive from day one, they know what they're doing, and so our production capacity has gone up. And so I've been forecasting a 20% growth for 2017. And I can tell you, when we close March, we're ahead of that growth. We've added 6 new employees, and we're going to add a new salesperson soon. And because Elmer shamed me, I'm going to do a new website. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Harry. So we have design fugitives. Duan. Did you see, in Milwaukee, when I hug people at times, they give me this side of their body. I tell them it has to be heart to heart. Heart to heart. So it has to be this way?
Demo.
Never this way. You know, this way means I don't love you. So when you hug in Milwaukee, please make it heart to heart.
Hi, my name is Tuan from Design Fugitives. We're a custom commercial art studio. If you came to the main lobby today, the dragon, that light piece there, that's Design Fugitives. We double our sales in 2016, and we're on projection to double that again this year. That's all I have.
So we have fixation bicycles. Nick.
Well, everyone, I'm Nick Ginster, founder of Fixation Bicycle Company. Fixation is a Milwaukee-based bicycle company. We design our own line of bicycles, parts, and accessories right here in Milwaukee. Our products are distributed and sold through bicycle distributors and bike shops around the nation and around the world. We have bike retailers in Tokyo, in Singapore, in China, all over the United States carrying our brand that's designed right here in Milwaukee. Our headquarters is located in River West. We also have a flagship retail store as well as our design center and warehouse in the River West area. And Scalerator has been a truly amazing experience for us. Very early on in the process, we set ourselves a very significant stretch goal for growth, and that was to grow our sales by 50% this year. We've told everybody we've met that that's what we're going to do, customers, friends, suppliers, and the most amazing thing about putting that goal out there is that it's coming back to us. I'm proud to report that as of Q1, we are up 83%. Additionally, we have 5 new employees. One of the most unique things I'll just share, we last couple years started a corporate bicycle program. We actually will design custom bicycles for corporations. They're used for incentives, for wellness programs, and this is something that we've been incubating all along. But throwing that growth goal out there and just talking to Vinny and some of the other Scalerators just got us to stretch our mind a little bit. So within the first 2 sessions of Scalerator, we designed a specific website around our corporate custom program. And I'm proud to report that in booked sales and things that are very strong in our pipeline, that program is up 200%. So I just want to take a minute to thank all of you. Thanks to everyone who supports Scale Up Milwaukee. It's very important for growth in our area, for our personal growth. And thanks for having us.
Thank you. Thank you, Nick. Where's Bill? Hiring on solutions.
All right. Good. You got skills, man.
Okay.
Hello, everybody.
My name is Bill Harrigan. My company is Harrigan Solutions. And in a state where there are 93,000 skilled jobs that can't be filled, and many of those are maintenance jobs. We make our business out of going into our customers' plants and maintaining their production equipment. And so we do this kind of like a pit crew where a customer might take 8 hours to do this maintenance work. We'll do that in 2, and in so doing, get their equipment back on the track, and that gives them better machine availability and reliability. From a growth standpoint, I'm happy to report, really happy, that today we're divesting ourselves of one part of our business that isn't so interesting, which will fund the rest of the business, and it's a huge swing, and I'm really happy about that. And that was kind of encouraged, or we kind of looked at that kind of thing. Second of all, from a customer standpoint, this quarter we'll double our service business, and by the end of the year we'll double it again. So from a capacity standpoint, we have 12 service people now. We'll have 24 by the end of the quarter, and another 40 by the end of the year. So this is important for the Scalerator scale-up people, or the ones that fund it. A critical component of what we do to get engagement with workers. So you might think, well, how is Bill going to find workers and engage them any better than our customers? Kevin Mulcahy wrote a book about designing or having an ideal employment experience, and how we business leaders have to look at that piece differently. And I would add to that a little bit, and that is to say that if we are able to design and implement an ideal training, a selection training, an employment experience, we're able to take people that are marginally employable and kind of groom them into family-supporting jobs. And so why do I bring this up? I'd like you to know that if we are providing a scenario where people, where if you envision someone who's not had a paycheck before, has that in their hand, they walk up the sidewalk to their house, in the door, and sit down at the table with a wife and two kids, and he slaps that thing down and he says, and the family says, oh, so that's what this looks like, okay? That's the American dream. I think we need to do a better job of recruiting, training, and providing the ideal employment experience so we can engage these people. The beneficiaries, in summary, are the state of Wisconsin, neighborhoods, families, and children. And anybody that would like to join me in that, I'd be delighted to chat with you.
Thank you.
So help you, Paul. Ah, yes. Paul on brand. There you go.
Hello, everyone. My name is Brian Brish. I'm the Director of Business Development for IAS. Industrial Automation Solutions helps manufacturing companies be more sustainable, profitable, and safe through the integration of robotics and automation technology. We've been very privileged to be a part of the Scalerator. We've learned extreme amount and have really improved our cash customers and capacity as part of our focus over the last 6 months. Just this first quarter, we're up 35% over last year. And with the business that we have in the pipeline, our pipeline is 4 to 5 times as big as it's ever been. Our goal of 100% growth over last year is well within reach. So very excited about that, and thank you.
Yeah, I want to thank everybody like Vinny, Elaine, Kevin, Elmer, Elizabeth, Heather, for including us in this program. We feel we're privileged by this. One of the big takeaways I guess I have is talking with all the people that we've been part of the program with is the importance of HR and the people that we have around us. So we've taken that to heart, and it's become a real focus for Brian and I, and that's so it was neat to see how many other companies have the same type of issues, even though they have nothing to do with engineering. So thanks everybody for sharing your stories and providing the feedback and guidance. Danielle, Nick, everybody else, appreciate it. Thank you.
Thank you.
So we call on Angel and Andrea.
Hello, everyone. My name is Angel Ramos Ortiz. I'm actually the founder and CEO of Innovative Dynamic Networks. This company was founded 12 years ago, And actually, we are from Racine. That's where our headquarters is. In terms of growth, since we started Scalerator, Innovative Dynamic Network had growth in terms of profit 35%. We have built a customer pipeline due to an aggressive focus that we are doing right now in Latin America. We have hired 5 new employees and 2 interns since we started Scalerator. And in the next year, we're opening an office in Puerto Rico. And in the next 5 years, we're opening 3 offices in Central America. So.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I just want to thank Elizabeth, Heather, everyone pretty much. We had a really, really amazing experience. There's things that, like Jessica mentioned last time, you know these things, but you put them into a different perspective, and we really take away a lot. And I thought it was a really amazing experience. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Well done. Thank you. Carlo Pambique.
Good afternoon, everybody. My name is Carl Brown. I'm with RBK Healthcare Marketing. And we've been in business for 18 years locally here. And we help market healthcare concerns on a local, national, and global basis, doing strategic and creative marketing. Scalerator has been a fantastic experience for us. Perhaps more than anything, taking the time to step back and look critically at your business and plan for the future of your business has been one of the key takeaways for us. Our business is on track to grow over 60% versus last year. And thank you. In the last 2 months, we have pitched business with 2 Fortune 500 companies. Yesterday, one of those Fortune 500 companies signed their first contract with us. Wow. And and I got word that the other Fortune 500 company, there will be some opportunity for us coming down the pipe. And we are also looking to hire 4 people as soon as we can find the right people. Yeah. So it's been a great experience for us. So thank you all.
Thank you.
And last but not the least, we have Joe of Rivera.
I am Joe Skatarczyk, one of the 2 owners of River Run Computers, and for almost 25 years now, we have been giving our clients peace of mind by making sure that their IT networks stay up and running and secure. So we're located up in Glendale, have clients throughout the Milwaukee metro area, and our growth story has a couple of key things to it. On the people side, we've got a new sales leader, Sean, that you all those of you that are Scalerator 4 met yesterday and today. Helping Sean out, we've hired a new business development person, and we've got 2 new client service reps on the way, so we're adding jobs as we go. On the product side, we have moved into, just at the start of this year, voice over IP systems, which is a completely new business for us, and Sean had actually led the charge on that as well. We've extended a couple of other product lines in terms of backup stuff, and we're getting much more involved with cybersecurity. So on the product side, there's all kinds of new and exciting things going on. Organizationally, we have made an investment in new structure in terms of, I'm not sure if any of you are familiar with the Traction program and entrepreneurial operating system. We're going down that path as well so that we can be better and smarter. And last but certainly not least, on the top line, our sales up year to date are 20% up over last year. So that's exciting. So that is the River Run growth story. Elizabeth has also told me what else to say, more or less. So I just wanted to sort of, in closing, you know, it was really interesting listening to everybody talk, 11 of us, right? I'm the 11th since Pat wasn't here. And Nick and Art and Angel and Andrea all said it was amazing. And it was. I mean, I think the rest of us would agree. It was an amazing experience to have this group of companies come together and with these incredible instructors and go through these six sessions of all these different things that are going to help us grow our businesses. And it's great, you know, to be the last person here, standing here talking about the growth story and all the jobs and all the sales and all the new offices and all the new products and all this amazing stuff. I mean, amazing is the only word. So, you know, first and foremost, big thanks to Don and Vinny and Babson, and especially to Elmer and Heather and Elizabeth for bringing this all together and bringing this group together. So I would also like to, you know, just welcome my fellow Scalerator 4 members and challenge all of us to keep that growth going. We've all got things in process. We've all got plans that we're working on, that we're working towards. So let's keep together. Let's keep that going. That's our challenge as individual business owners here in Milwaukee and as we expand out, sounds like all over the world. And to continue the learning, you know, while our time together in the classroom is ending, you know, this just starts the rest of it, to be able to continue applying this, to continue learning this stuff. And Angel, you made the point this morning that for those of you that weren't there, you know, yesterday and today we talked a lot about sales and sales management and all that kind of stuff. And it's too bad we had this at the end, but you know, something's got to be last. So let's stay together. Let's get together. And I don't know, we can talk about this. Do a quarterly gathering. You know, let's talk about, okay, we've now been able to apply all the sales stuff that we did just learn today. Something's got to be last. So let's coordinate that. Let's keep in touch. Let's stay together and help each other out. You know, there's a lot of good synergy, a lot of good energy. You know, we all had a great time. Again, it was amazing. So thanks to you guys. It's been a pleasure.
Thank you.
Yeah, from my side, Dan, you want to come closer? For my side, and I give the mic to Dan briefly before we introduce Dave. I want to say I want to say a big thank you. For 4 years now, this city, you, the people, you've made me a better person, a better professional, with your feedback and everything. And you've made the Scalerator to be stronger because the feedback we get from you has enabled us to sort of improve a lot of things. So I want to say thank you, and thank you. And the only way also we want to say thank you, continue saying thank you to you, is that we want you to continue to grow. Yeah. The moment someone starts growing, it means death is setting in. When you grow, it's a vital sign that something good is happening. And that growth is going to enable you to discover areas, patches that needs to be fixed, things that have to be innovated. And so we encourage you, please, keep growing, but with criteria, with order. Don't ever be in the bottom right corner. Never. Thank you again, and Dan, I want to say, and then I want to introduce
just last words. It's really amazing to hear those stories. Keep telling them. It's incredibly inspiring to other people like yourselves who have businesses or are thinking of starting businesses, buying businesses. To hear the growth stories is essential. It's not nice, it's essential. You know, we have this, you've probably heard about unicorns. You know, that a lot of regions in the world say, oh, we need our unicorns. Unicorns are mythical beasts. You're workhorses. Workhorses plod away year after year delivering results. And Jerry, I don't know if you know this, but I'm sure you're going to remember this. If you grow at 17% for 17 years, in 17 years, your business is 17 times bigger. Remember that. 17 by 17 by 17. Sometimes it'll turn into 70. But just keep growing and keep growing and keep growing. Big things happen as a result. So thank you all very much. Dave, I'll turn it over to you.
All right. Thank you again.
You too.
Well, I'm gonna close this out here, but I want to again thank a number of people who are here. Elmer, Elizabeth, Heather, if we could all give them a round of applause. Again, Vinny, Dan, Julia, And I just also want to thank the GMC board for what they came up with this concept and putting the investment behind it and what it's meant out there in the community. I'm Dave Werner. I'm president and CEO here at Park Bank in Milwaukee and also co-chair with Jerry Gendusa of the Scale Up Steering Council. And instead of saying why I got involved, I'll just share with you what's happened since I got involved with Scale Up. And at Park Bank, we changed our vision statement and narrowed it in the last year. And our vision now is to be the best bank for growing businesses in southeastern Wisconsin. And the reason for that, for us, selfishly, is growing businesses have greater needs of a bank. I've got a customer here who just mentioned to me for growth. He's asking to increase his line of credit. I heard somebody else say that they had to move and get a new loan, but not for me, but good for you. Because the other reason why I am involved is, and I'm a lifelong member of this community, and a rising tide lifts all boats. And with growing companies, you inspire others, you pull them along with you, you create that tide, and that's better for me, it's better for everybody in our community. That's exciting, that says something about our community overall. So that's why I am involved, that's what's happened since I've been involved, and I want to thank you and congratulate you for what you're doing. As Joe said, I also, you know, welcome and want to see that you continue to invest in what you're doing in your businesses. You know, no fear, push ahead. Growth is great, and the impact that you're going to have in this community is better for all of us. So I want to thank you for that as well. So on behalf of the Scale Up Steering Committee, we just want to congratulate you, Scalerator 4, and looking forward to hearing more about you in the future. So thank you.